Hi guys, my name is Neha Gupta and I'm your mentor for current affairs at this organization. So majority of you are already familiar with me, but those who are coming for the first time on this platform, let me introduce myself. So I provide the current affairs for phase one of majority of the banking examination. And today on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti, I have come with most important current affairs so that you can start your day with a meaningful activity and achieve your goals in your life. That is my wish for you or for all of you guys. So let's begin our day with the most important current affairs. But before that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. And also join our Telegram group in order to get the free quizzes. And here comes the page where we will be discussing all the things that we are going to discuss in this lecture in a very brief manner. So let me introduce you with all the topics that we are going to cover in this video. So the first topic is about the decade of health aging that has been announced by UN. So this decade of health aging is very important from exam point of view, and we will be covering each and everything related to this decade and UN in the first question itself. Then we have the URISE portal, which has been launched by a state government. So which state government it is and what this portal is for, we will be discovering all these things in the second question. Then India's assistance for Honeymadhu International Airport, which is not in India. So this is an international airport, basically an airport located in another country. So that's why this is very important from the exam point of view. Then about the Venus mission. Now the importance is not required to be highlighted by me. It is very relevant for your examination. You can yourself decipher this thing. Then we have Sahyog Evam Upahar Yojana, which is again a state scheme. Then we have US Citizen Diplomacy Award 2020. And lastly, we have the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. Recently, RBI has excluded a bunch of banks from its second schedule. So it is very important for those who are appearing for any kind of banking examination to know which banks have been excluded, why have they been excluded, and what is the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. So all these things are very important, and we will be discussing all these things at the last section of our video. So do watch this video till the end in order to gather the fruitful information. So let's begin the video for today with our first question. So which decade is celebrated as the decade of healthy aging by UN? First of all, let us understand what this healthy aging decade is. Aging is connected with old age. Healthy aging refers to promoting ease of life. Ease of living for the elderly people. So what does UN aim to do in this decade? UN aims to collaborate with other stakeholders, with nations and with governments in order to better the ease of living for older people, for the aging population of this world. So I hope that from this simplification, it is very easy for you guys to remember it now. And now let's discuss the answer of this question. So the answer is 2020 to 2030. Now this has been announced on a very special day. So what this day is, it is the International Day of Older People. Now can you tell me that on which date is this day celebrated? What is the date? It is October 1st. So yesterday only we had observed this International Day of Older People, which is observed by United Nations. So this is the crux of this news that we need to keep in our mind in order to clear any kind of banking examination, particularly phase one. I am talking about here that this is very important from the phase one examination. Next comes our second question, which is about which state has launched the U-Rise portal for providing career counseling assistance to students. So this question is itself telling us the purpose of this U-Rise portal. So what is the purpose? Purpose is to provide the career counseling assistance to students. Clear? It is very obvious. Then I have highlighted this U-Rise portal. Now let me tell you the answer of this question, because the answer and this name is quite synonymous. You will easily remember the name of this portal and as well as the state. So can you guess which state is it? It is Uttar Pradesh. So that is why I have told you that they are synonymous, because the U is common. And from here you can easily remember that this U-Rise portal has been launched by the Uttar Pradesh government. And what is the purpose? To promote, to provide career counseling assistance to students. And how can you remember this purpose of this U-Rise portal better? It is through its full form. So let's jump on to the full form of this U-Rise portal. So in this picture, as I have already told you, that pictures do help us a lot to remember things. That is why I have taken this picture from the official website of U-Rise. Guys, here I would like to caution you that you need to be very careful while looking for or while watching any kind of video provided by any kind of mentor, because I have seen this thing myself that many mentors on this platform are not providing the authentic news. So that is why you need to be very careful. So here the full form is written. U stands for Unified, Reimagined, Innovation for Students Empowerment. That is the full form. Here I can't do anything. I cannot deploy any kind of trick, because this full form has to be learned by you. So I can't do anything in this. You have to remember this full form. Yeah, but in case if you have remembered this full form, then the purpose is automatically learned by you. So you need not to put any kind of extra effort in remembering the purpose of this portal. So that's all we need to discuss about this portal. And now we will be jumping on to our third question. And if you have any kinds of doubts, do feel free to ask me in the comment section or in the Telegram channel. Then the next question is, where is the Halim Madhu International Airport located? So let's discuss the answer of this question, and then we will be discussing about the news. Why is this airport here? What is the importance of this international airport? So the answer to this question is Maldives. Recently, the news is that India has announced to help Maldives in expanding this international airport. So what is the keywords here? What is the thing that we need to keep in mind from the examination point of view? Just that this international airport belongs to Maldives. This is the only thing that you need to keep in mind, besides a fact that India has extended a line of credit of 800 million. That is not extended this time. It has been extended earlier, but why are we discussing this? The reason behind discussing this is that out of this 800 million line of credit, this expenditure will be adjusted. So this expansion is a part of this 800 million line of credit. Now guys, do pay attention to this thing, that all these things are just expected. Right now India has just announced to help Maldives, and the funding of expanding this airport is also likely to be funded by this line of credit. So what is the purpose of me discussing all this with you? The reason is simple, that we have to keep in mind just two things. First, this airport is in Maldives. Second, that India has extended $800 million assistance to Maldives. What is the purpose of this assistance? Infrastructure development in Maldives. That is all we need to keep in mind. Forget everything, any other thing about the news that I have told you recently. The things that I have told you right now is for your understanding, is to tell you that how this 800 million assistance is not being used for the expansion of this airport. It is just expected to be used. So do remember these things. And now, yeah, I have a question for you. You have to tell me the capital of Maldives in the comment section below. And I'm very glad with the response that I'm getting from my students. My students are continuously replying me in the comment section. Their answers or the questions I ask them in the session. So do tell your answer as well. Do not shy away thinking that my answer would be wrong. Just be brave and give your answers. Even if it is wrong, then you will get to know the right answer in the session itself and you will remember it better. So do not shy away. Just mention your answers in the comment section. Now comes our next question. So let's quickly discuss this question, which is about which country has announced to collaborate with India for its Venus mission. First of all, let's discuss about Venus mission. So what is the most important thing about Venus is the launch year. Obviously, so ISRO has announced to launch Venus mission by the year 2025. Now guys, since this COVID situation is ongoing, recently this the organization ISRO, that is Indian Space Research Organization, has announced to launch Venus mission in 2025. So at present, this is the exact launch year. And in the future, there are chances that this launch year can change. But you need not to worry about that. If this happens, then we will surely cover it in our sessions. But right now, the thing that you need to cover is the year 2025. That Shukrayaan will be launched in 2025. That's one thing that we need to cover about this thing, about this news. Now, the second thing of importance is this question itself. Which country? So it is France. France has announced to collaborate with India for its ISRO mission, for its Shukrayaan mission. So what will France do in this mission? France will equip Shukrayaan with a satellite, and the name of that satellite is Viral. Basically, Viral is not a satellite, it's an instrument. And what is the purpose of Viral is to study the atmosphere of Venus. So Viral is the first instrument, is the first foreign instrument that will be equipped on an Indian satellite. And what is the name of that satellite? It is Shukrayaan. So on Shukrayaan, this Viral instrument of France will be equipped. What is the purpose of equipping Shukrayaan with Viral? The reason is to study Venus better. Now guys, the thing that you need to keep in mind is the full form of Viral. Yes, Viral too has a full form. And what is the full form? The full form is Venus, V for Venus, I and R stands for infrared, A for atmospheric gases, and L for linker. So if you bifurcate the Viral, then you will be able to remember this full form better. So you can also take a screenshot of this slide if you want to, in order to remember the spelling better or the full form better, or you can also write it in a piece of paper in your notes. Even if you are not making notes, then you don't need to worry because I am providing all these news items in detail in Spotlight magazine. So you can download it for free from our website, and there you can find all the news items that are being discussed in this session and that have already been discussed in the previous sessions also. Now comes our next question, that is, which state has announced to give 30% of the new public distribution system shops to women for their empowerment? Quite easy to understand, there is nothing to it to elaborate. So the answer of this question is Rajasthan. Rajasthan has announced to give 30% of their new PDS system to women. Purpose is for their empowerment. Now guys, do you remember that I have mentioned about a scheme? So what is that scheme? The scheme is Sahyog Evam Upahar Yojana. Remember, I have highlighted this new this scheme in the index itself. So what is this scheme? This is the scheme of Rajasthan government for the daughter's marriage. So under this scheme, the needy and poor people get money from the government for the marriage of their daughters. Now, how can you remember it better? First of all, the state, you have to remember it anyway. You have to remember that which state has launched this scheme. Now, I can simplify this scheme so that you don't have to put in extra effort in remembering the purpose of this scheme. So, Sahyog is support. Evam is and in English. Upahar is gift. When do we give gifts? Obviously at an occasion. So from upahar, from gift, you can easily remember that we are talking about the marriage. Marriage of whom? Obviously girls, because in India at present also we are the parents of girls face this dilemma of paying for dowry or for the expenses of marriage. This is quite a sad scenario, because in the 21st century still the parents of daughters need the support of governments for marrying of their daughters. But this is true. So support, that is sahyog given by government to the poor families. Gift, from upahar you can remember that this support is given for the marriage of the daughters. And who needs the support? Obviously needy people. So this scheme targets poor and needy people. So that's all about this question and about this scheme. I hope that I am able to simplify it for you guys, and you can now remember it better. Now we have come to our next question, that is, who has won the US Citizen Diplomacy Award 2020? First of all, let us discuss what this award is. So this award, as the name suggests, US Citizen Diplomacy Award. Definitely, this award has been instituted by US for the citizens of United States. Diplomacy means what? Means to promote the relations, political, economic or diplomatic relations of United States with other countries. So this award is given to the citizens of US who have done extraordinary work in promoting US in other countries, in promoting US ties with other countries. So I hope that from this bifurcation of the award, you can easily remember the purpose of this award. Now, the purpose is not very important for you to remember. It's just for your understanding. Even if you don't remember the purpose, don't worry, because you have to remember only two things here: the winner of this award and the name of this award. That is all that we need to keep in mind from the examination point of view. So now, who has won this award? It is Muhammad Amin Ahmad. He has won this award for promoting US ties in other countries. And that's all we need to discuss about this question. And here comes the last question of our day, that is, how many banks have been excluded from the second schedule of RBI Act 1934? Now let us first discuss what is the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. Second schedule of RBI Act 1934 mentions the or lists the banks which are scheduled banks. So what is the purpose of this second schedule? To detail scheduled banks, to provide details about scheduled banks. Now recently, a total number of, can you guess what is the answer? How many banks have been excluded? So a total number of 6 public sector banks have been excluded from this list of scheduled commercial banks. Now, you need to understand why have they been excluded. The reason behind excluding them is their merger with other public sector banks. So after the merger, the units have become one, and the total number of public sector banks have been reduced from 27 to 12. And therefore, these six banks have been excluded from the list of from the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. Now, guys, you must be thinking that which banks are these? So let's quickly discuss the names of those banks. In this picture, we can clearly see that which banks are being merged. Oriental Bank of Commerce and United Bank are being merged with PNB. That is why these two banks have been excluded from the Schedule 2 of RBI Act 1934. Then we have Canara Bank and Syndicate Bank. Canara Bank is the anchor bank. Remember this thing, that the first banks here are the anchor bank, are the major bank under which these other banks are being merged. So Syndicate Bank is being merged with Canara Bank. Then we have Union Bank, Andhra Bank and Corporation Banks merger. So here Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank are being merged with Union Bank. Then at the last we have Indian Bank and Allahabad Bank. So these are the total six banks which have been excluded from the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. And second schedule is for the scheduled commercial banks. These are the things, guys, you need to keep in mind from the examination point of view. Now, if you want to click a screenshot of this screen, then you can do so, because this photo from the Hindu is very relevant for your examination. Why? Firstly, it is telling about the size of the merged entity. So after merging PNB, OBC and United Bank, the PNB will become the second largest PSB of India. And what would be the size of PNB? 18 lakh crore. And similarly, the other banks have been mentioned. So you can click a screenshot of this picture in order to keep this thing in your mind. And even if you don't want to click a screenshot of this blurred picture, so you can go through the spotlight of September last year, because this was announced in September last year. So you can go through this September spotlight of 2019 and cover this news from there. And here comes our session to an end. I hope that you have liked the session, and in case you have any kinds of doubts, suggestions, advice, you can ask us or give your suggestions in the comment section below. Do like this video if you have really liked the content, and stay tuned to this video. Thank you so much.